Hello gamers, and welcome back to another Gamed In review. Today I'm going to be reviewing a World War II strategy game known as Combat Commander by GMT Games. I just recently got this game in the mail today, so I have not opened it or had time to look at it. I have, however, looked up rules online and read them thoroughly. And as far as I can tell, this is probably one of the most complex games I've ever played, with a massive 21-page rulebook. Let's open it up. On the back of it, this game says that the complexity is a 5, with the solitaire suitability is a 3. So complexity is normal, and the solitaire suitability is low. This game is copyright 2013. This is version 2.0, from what I understand. And let's just get this thing open. I'm not opening it right at all, am I? So, this game comes with several cards. It's a big, major card-driven game. That's basically how this game is going on. There's no dice, there's nothing. So it'll come with a rule book and a playbook. So both these books, you need to read this book before you start playing, and then this book is to set up scenarios. It's like, this game is like a very complex version of MMR 44. So you have three decks of cards, one for the American, one for the Russian, and one for the German player. You will never have Russians and Americans on the same team. From what I understand, in the same scenario, that's what I understand, that's what I've gotten from this game. I've never played this game before, so bear with me here. From what I've read, this is a really cool game. Okay, so you got, okay, so these are the counters. These are a lot of counters. There's a lot of them. Yeah, these look like very high quality cardboard counters. Not as high quality as one of the games that I have that I shall be reviewing very soon, but still, they are very high quality for today's standards. Alright, here's the little track display chart. Okay, you got your victory track right here, your casualty track, your time track, your weapons, and a little bit of and reference charts, which is always really good. Alright, this looks a little bit weird here. Let me just open this up. Order of battle. Some more reference charts. You got the American order of orders of battle. You have then the American support table. You have the German orders of battle and the German support table. And of course, Russian order of battle and Russian support table. So on and so forth. So you got those. And then you have another reference chart. Just for referencing, because the game is so complex. And then you've got a terrain reference chart as well. So a lot of reference charts. So that just shows the complexity of this game. And if they're saying a complexity level of 5, I'm going to say that you might not want to play a complex game level of 10 if you're new to these type of games. And okay, so here's the game board itself. I have heard that not very many gamers like this type of style because it's not as fun to play as on a cardboard board, as I can understand that. It's a lot cheaper to buy a game with these. It comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 double-sided maps. So you can have 12 different game maps. So tons of different scenarios. And a unit tray. Thank you, GMT Games. Not very many other games will come with a unit tray or any of these counter trays to help separate your units. So this is very good for GMT Games. Doesn't look too high quality, but it looks like it's good enough to do what it's supposed to do. You want to get a better one? You're going to have to buy it. I'm not going to buy another one. I'm glad that it has this. If it didn't come with this, I'd probably just use plastic bags. Forgive me, please. Now let's open this up just to get a good look at what this is here. Just reference cards right here. So you got reference cards for your deck. You got the German fate deck, the Russian fate deck, and the American fate deck. Oh, this is the initiative card. I'm not going to sit here and get a whole game setup. This is more or less an unboxing where I get to look at it and explain my thoughts, initial thoughts on this. If you want to find a game where it's more in depth, there's tons out there. I'm just doing an unboxing here. Sorry if that upset some of you. My initial thoughts, this is going to be a really fun game. My secondary thoughts from after reading the rules is that this game is pretty complex, and the only way that I'm going to find people to play it is people who know how to play these games. Something that I really find interesting about this game, there's no dice. Even though there are dice rolls, there are no dice. It's completely card-driven, 100%. And the dice rolls, you draw a card to roll the dice, which is very interesting, very unique, and I like it. I mean, it's kind of weird not having the dice that you roll, but you can't mess up the board with someone going crazy and rolling the dice. I mean, that can be avoidable, but still. I like the unit tray. I really do. This adds a plus. That's a very big plus to it. The maps look very nice. I like what the maps look like. These are really nice looking units. I'm going to say that it is worth the $50. If you, depending on when you buy it, it could be up worth of 70. I got this on sale from Amazon for 50. The link to this game will be found in the description, or it will just be found. Yeah, you'll just see, you'll know where the link is to the to where I bought it. I do highly recommend this game. This game looks really awesome, and I can't wait to play it. And it's very nice. The one thing that's really bugging me though is the rules. The way the rules are made, it's the paper you can buy at office supply stores. You know how you get some little books and they actually are like that nice magazine almost paper. Those rules are nice. So like they put a little bit more thought into the type of paper you're using for your rules. Just my thought. Like I said, the rules are very long. 21 pages of rules. Actually 23 pages of rules with a massive index in the back. They even have a glossary in the front. So that's the game right now. It looks pretty cool. Can't wait to play it. I will definitely show a future review of this game where I come back to this and show you my complete thoughts. I'm just trying to get a video out there. I'm sorry that I couldn't do any more, but I made this game pretty late. Happy New Year, by the way. I'm going to rate this game with a game end review score of 8. So far, that's my thought. Game didn't review score 8. When I come back, I might give it a different one, but so far, it's an 8, as was said. Up next, I will be reviewing the 1977 version of Avalon Hill's The Battle of Gettysburg.